삼성 갑들 놈.
예, 예.
자, 여러분들이 그토록 원하시던 팟캐스트 3의 번외편, 이승철 선수와 샘슨 다우다의 만남을 추진했습니다. 두 분의 대화를 저희는 번역을 좀 해주고 싶은데, 이승철 선수께서 샘슨 다우다에게 뭐 축하 멘트를 하시면 저희가 번역을 좀 하는 것도. 예.
아, 아놀드 클래식 우승 정말 축하한다고 전해드리죠.
He congrats for your winning in the Arnold Classic.
아주 멋있었다고.
It was really good.
Thanks, man.
Outstanding.
궁금하신 거 뭐 여쭤보셔도 좋을 것 같습니다.
아, 이제 그 우리나라 이제 보디빌딩 팬들이 이제 궁금해할 것 같아서 뭐 하루에 끼니와 하루 식사를 몇 끼 하냐 그런 그것과 이제 사이클 이제 운동 사이클을 며칠 분할로 몇 분할로 하냐.
So for the general knowledge for the body, yeah. Korean South Korean bodybuilding fan, so what's your diet look like? How many meals do you taking in, and what's your training split?
Generally, right now anyway, or today, normally 6 meals a day. First meal, my meals during my diet and prep are normally exactly the same. But what happens is the portions come down in okay. carbs and stuff like that. So first meal is always eggs and oats. Second meal, sweet potato and steak. Third meal, rice and chicken. And then during the off season, we swap rice for mince and pasta. Fourth meal is rice and chicken again.
It's very
straightforward, you know. Fifth meal, same thing, normally rice and chicken. And then last meal will be salmon. Mm. So it's quite steady like that. And obviously where you have the supplements as well into it. Well, my meals normally just stay quite steady.
Do you know how many calories are you taking right now?
Right from then on, we're probably anywhere between 5,500 or 6,000 calories.
Wow. So, for just the maintain?
Or just to maintain. To maintain right now, that's one thing. Next month, I start the off season, and then you probably go up to 7,500 calories at that point. So, yeah.
Wow.
How about training split?
My one is quite simple because I put my weakest body part I want to bring up first in the week. So, Monday I'll train back first, and then quads and hamstrings on Tuesday, shoulders and abs on Wednesday, arms and traps Thursday, Friday. I normally do glutes, off season I have Friday off, but during prep I do train glutes. Saturday, chest, and that's it, chest and calves on Saturday, and that's it.
So you do training once a week for body part?
Yeah.
Yeah, 딱 한 번씩만 운동을 하는 건 똑같은 것 같습니다.
브로스플릿.
나는
이제 체중이 이제 갑자기 늘었잖아요. 작년에 이제 시합 뛰고 올림피아 준비하면서 갑자기 엄청나게 늘었는데 체중이 늘면서 좀 힘들었던 점이
오 진짜 중요하죠.
오, 오케이 오케이. So he is wondering, he's asking you that you increased the weight suddenly. So yeah. is there any problems? No. Is there you feeling any? Anything else?
Other than what I feel is I feel like I'm carrying a lot of weight. It feels uncomfortable.
Is there any difficult side effects or whatever?
For me, when we, you know, I've grown steadily and because of what we're putting on is real mass and not just low fat water, it doesn't feel any side effects in it. I still have a great appetite. I still eat. I can still train. I can still walk around. I can still do everything else. What it does feel like though, it feels like it's a lot of weight. You're a big guy and you feel... You feel very uncomfortable in public because this is something that you don't see often, and you know, walking around in public is a lot of attention and there's a lot of things. And you know, other than that, you know, I'm breaking furniture at home all the time.
It's $50 a chair, right?
You gotta test it first. You don't just sit down, you know. But you know, other than that, you know, because we've done it. Steadily, even though people think that it's
sudden.
Remember, I've been doing this for 10 years. Every year, I put on about 10 pounds a year.
Oh, okay.
So it's been steadily for us. Mm. And where we are now, we're probably at a part where it's a threshold where most guys are fighting to be 300 pounds. I'm 300 pounds completely. I'm doing prep. You know, 300 pounds isn't a lot anymore for me.
Oh, okay.
So now I'm able to push the boundary even more, but it's happening quite gradually and steadily. So when you're doing it like that, it doesn't feel like a ballooning process. You don't all of a sudden feel extremely like you have breathing problems or heart problems and that. You feel a lot more healthy when you do it. So it's just because it's been gradual and because our diet is, like you see, very simple.
Mm-hmm.
Very clean, very simple food. That's all my diet is. And because of that, I don't have a lot of side effects. Something my body's already used to that regime over and over and over and months again. So for me, there's not really much changes in the way I feel between that and
then,
that, other than me knowing that it feels like I'm carrying a lot of weight.
이 웨이트 트레이닝 할 때 이제 가장 중요한 점 세 가지를 꼽자면.
Wow. What's your the 48 weight training? What's your the most important point for 3 points if you?
Well, in terms of training.
Yeah, in terms of training for the weight training.
My one is I kind of vary around because my training I always go, you know, heavy compound movement first and then isolation second. So me is high volume all the time.
High volume, heavy weight,
and one of you know drop sets, supersets, all that. It works a
intensely.
Lot. Very high okay. intensity is where I've always trained, and this works great for me. Like if I go to the gym, I don't like spending energy more than an hour in the gym.
Oh really?
You know, for me, it's, everything over that is too long. It's dragging out. Is keep it extremely intense for a really short time.
Wow.
So you can really feel your heart grow. So it becomes. Not just a weight training session, it almost becomes like a cardio session at the same time.
I don't think anyone can last over 1 hour with Milos.
And that's exactly it.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah, so it's that short but very intense and heavy training.
일반 이제 보디빌딩 팬들도 그렇고 이제 심사 기준이 명확하지 않다 생각하는데 그리고 이제 뭐 그 점에 대해서 어떻게 생각하고 뭐 바라는 점이 있다면 뭐
다시
심사 기준은 불명확한데 대중들이 그렇게 생각을 한다. 불명확하다고. 근데 이제 바라는 점이 있다. 거기에 대해서 어떻게
so 생각하세요? Audience, you know, audience thinks that is the judging criteria is not clear.
Yeah.
So what do you think about that?
I don't think so. I think you know what is judging has always been the way the judging has been, and because we tend to forget the main boundaries of judging because what happens is with social media and everything else they switch towards one way based off social media and what the judge is saying. Because I've noticed the last what, 2 years now, it's been all conditioning, nothing else.
Mm.
It's like your proportions don't count anymore, your symmetry, your flow, they don't prioritize that anymore. And it's been like, because you haven't had guys that have had symmetry and flow at that level, so you have to come down to one thing, which is conditioning only. But since now that you're having more guys that are more proportioned, more symmetrical, more aesthetic, you can then just put your whole judging criteria on.
With conditioning on the diet.
You know, because I can't be bigger than you, out-symmetry you, out-balance you, but then you beat me just on conditioning and you win. You know, it has to be a more rounded thing. So I think for the audience watching it, because for a long time they've seen just the most conditioned guy win. And now they're looking going, hey, what's going on? They don't understand that the first thing you do when athletes walk on stage is, how symmetrical is it?
Mm-hmm.
How complete is it? How balanced is it?
Yes.
If you don't have those boxes ticked, it doesn't matter if you're
the most efficient. The detail doesn't matter.
Those details don't matter because you're already losing points because your legs don't match your upper body, your arms are too small, your shoulders are not there. You know, you're lacking body parts compared to somebody that's trained all those body parts to make them complete. So I think this is now where you're seeing a shift in it and people are not quite, they don't understand that fully.
유튜버들이 많은데 이제 내추럴 얘기하면서 그런 친구들이 많은데 그런 친구들 말고 이제 또 뭐 스테로이드 얘기하면서 스테로이드 사용하면 그냥 근육이 는다는 그런 말도 안 되는 소리를 하는 친구들이 있다.
Mm-hmm.
그거에 대해서 어떻게 생각하냐는.
So you know the YouTubers, the natural YouTubers, there's people that who using gear or PEDs, yeah. And they're saying, okay, if you use steroids, you're gonna grow. What do you think about those guys?
There's so many wrong information
is floating around. You just take shots and you get 50 pounds of muscle.
Nah, I just think, man, you know what? There's always so many information and so much false information online. Yeah. And I just want to say, look, anybody that is watching, be very careful because a lot of these people, they think they know. What happens? They think they know how bodybuilding works. And yet we're here telling you we train 6 days a week. We eat 7 meals a day consistently. I've been doing this 10 years every day without missing a single day of training or a single meal constantly to get where I am now. So if you think you could take a shot and just wake up the next morning and be like that, man, I think everybody will wake up the next morning looking like this. So it doesn't work that easy. Yeah. So please take care of your health, man.
I think that makes the shine bodybuilding more shine because it's not somebody. If everyone has six pack, no one wants six pack. You know
exactly, exactly. And this is just it. You know, so this is why the sport is so hard, and this is why the sport is so great because it's not something. You know, it's your physical body. It's not something you can buy.
Yes,
it's not something you can win.
You can get surgery.
You can get surgery. You can't fake this. Mm-hmm. There's nothing you could possibly do. To wake up the next morning and go, okay, I want a big arms, I want to be, and I'm just gonna get it. you have to sacrifice, you have to work, and you have
to put the time, effort. Yeah.
You have to. There's no shortcut. There is literally no
money.
Yeah, you know. So this is why I'm just saying, like, ignore the people that talk a lot. They have no idea.
영국에 살고 있죠 지금. 삼성 영국에 살고 있는데 지금 이제 오픈 보디빌딩을 하기 힘드니까 보디빌더들이 굉장히 많이 없어지는 한국에서는 거의 몇 명 없잖아요 지금 오픈 보디빌더.
맞습니다.
영국은 어떤지 궁금하다고.
So you live in UK, in Korea right now, yeah. because you cannot earn a lot of money as a living as an open bodybuilder. Yeah. How is it like in Korea? Is a decreasing trend. How is it in UK?
I mean, UK, I think, is actually an increasing trend. In
oh, really?
Yeah, because I think, because I think in the past, two, 3 years, we've seen more UK pros. There have been more pro shows in UK, so mm-hmm. they've allowed more guys that are actually in the sport to win their pro card. And, you know, if one person does it, another person wants to do it. And then when the other person does it, another person wants to do it. So it creates this tradition where more people that see it's possible, more people want to do it. And then that creates an avenue for having more and more pro shows to happen. So if there is more pro shows in Korea that advertise for open pro bodybuilders, there will be more people that want to reach it. But if there isn't, because I know a long time ago in the UK, before, you know, two bros took over, there was only one pro card a year for anybody, you know. Then you only had one person turn pro in a whole year.
Whole year.
Everybody, all of us, we wanted that pro card, but only one person. So it felt like there wasn't a lot of people. And when you know that you're training 5, 6, 7, 8 years, you haven't won your pro card because it's just one, you end up just saying, okay, I'm giving up. But when they create more opportunities for a lot of people to earn their pro card, now you have more guys coming. So now you see in the UK, there's a lot of pros. There are a lot of people getting more interested because there's more opportunity for that. Mm. So I think it always comes with the idea of it's not just if people are interested or not, it's more the opportunity that's provided to them. If the opportunity is there, I'm sure there will be a lot of people
that will take it,
you know.
We also have a lot of opportunity of double getting a pro card,
yeah.
but it seems like they really want to go, don't want to go the open. It yeah. takes too much time. And they want to get, they go straight to the men's physique or mm-hmm. maybe classic physique.
Mm-hmm. But that's true, I mean, that's it. But you know, at the end of the day, the prestige, the idea why open class is so hard is because of that. Mm-hmm. And that's why it's such a elite thing to be able to push to that point where you're an open bodybuilder. You know, yeah, you can do classic, yeah, you can go men's physique, but at the end of the day, open is still the one that everybody looks at. They want to see the monsters, they want to see the big guys. And that's why it's so hard to achieve that. But at the same time, it's still the main bread of bodybuilding. Mm-hmm. So you have the other classes, but we all still wait to, you know, we go to shows, we still want to see the big guys, you know? So yeah, I do understand why guys don't have the patience to wait that long. Mm-hmm. But then you have to look at it in terms of classic and men's physique. They are open ground for you to start competing.
Yeah.
There's opportunity to start there. The more you grow, the more you push up classes. How many guys have we seen now? Derek came from 212. He's mm-hmm. open. Hadi. 212. Mm-hmm. Open. You know, a lot of guys have come through that opportunity.
Yeah, men's physique going to class physique, exactly. class physique going physique to the
open. Mm-hmm. So this is the opportunity is there. So it's just a time of growth.
개인적으로 이제 심사 올림피아 작년 올림피아를 보고서 이제 뭐 하디 추파이나 데릭이나 뭐 키 작은 친구들 212에서 올라온 친구들이 작고. 작으니까 그만큼 이제 큰 선수들보다는 좀 뭐 음식이나 이런 것들 좀 유지하는 데 있어서 더 약간의 좀
어드밴티지
더 어드밴티지 유리하지
않을까 작은 친구들이 좀 더 유리하지 않을까
큰 사람들은 그만큼 좀 더 힘들고 체중 유지하고
What do you think is for the your personal opinion? Because in Olympia, Monique Walker or Hadi came from
sure, two, guys.
Sean Clarida went to 212 to the open.
Yeah.
Maybe, do you think they have an advantage since they are shorter? Maybe in the food-wise and maintaining their weight because they don't have to be, because they're shorter, they don't have to be like 300 pounds to be compete. So do you think?
I think it's still hard for everybody. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, it's about how complete and how full you can make your physique. Yeah, with a shorter guy, you do have the advantage of being able to fill out your frame a lot quicker.
Mm-hmm.
But the disadvantage of that is when a taller guy does the same.
You look like a miniature.
There's nothing you can do about it. There's no leeway about it. There's just nothing you can do about it. So although, yeah, it's almost like a give and take. You know, one hand, you can be shorter and fit out your physique and get there quicker. Or you could be taller, take you a long time to get there. But when you do,
you're unbeatable.
There you go. So I think this is how it goes. There's always something for everybody.
완벽하게 채우길 바란다.
Oh, he wants to fill you up like beautifully.
Oh, wow.
he wishes it.
Thank you. 마지막으로 이제 어떤 선수로 남고 싶은지 기억이 되고 싶은지.
For the last question, what do you want to be remembered as a competitor?
Well, to be fair, I just wanted to be the guy that, you know, I represented this sport with my best of my ability. You know, I want to inspire a lot of people that came from my position. A lot of people that, you know, they were at that brink where they've given everything they can and they're about to give up and they're about to feel like, you know what, maybe this isn't for me, you know, and they're about to walk away and say, look, you don't have to have it from the beginning. You know, a lot of people get in this sport, they think, you know, they look at the success of those people that just come out and they think, oh, it's just that easy. If it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen at all. So I wanted to kind of spread the idea that it doesn't work that way. You will get knocked back over and over and over and over again. And you will feel like maybe this isn't for me. And you will feel like it doesn't happen when you're ready for it. It won't just happen just like that. But if you stick in there, you hold on to it, you hold your dream and you keep pushing, you get it. You know, I'm walking example of that. So I want to say, hopefully inspire other people to do the same and realize it's not going to have to be bodybuilding. Whatever you're doing, it doesn't happen straight away. It doesn't happen when you want it. But if you just stick with it, you will get it.
I'm going to beat Samsung. I'm going to believe it.
Why not?
So he's mentally 6 weeks out from the Kelly Pro.
Oh,
so,
yeah. Nice. Yeah.
마지막으로 한글, 저기 우리 한국말 한마디 같이 하면 안 되냐?
한국말 한마디.
Can you say him? Can you follow him in Korean?
한국말.
So he's gonna for Korean fans.
Yeah. Korean fans. 무슨 말을?
삼촌 같은 놈.
삼촌 같은 놈. I think he knows it.
He became a meme because of his famous meme.
Samsung Captain Nom.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Samsung 같은 놈 화이팅.
삼성 같은
3, 2, 1.
삼성 같은 놈
화이팅.
And you just have to translate. Take out the Samsung.
Yeah.
You can replace with the signature.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can replace any name.
Okay,
good luck.
Finish.